الله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور انفسنا ومن سيئات اعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد ان لا اله الا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد ان سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمد عبده ورسوله اما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته Allah the Almighty, He mentions a very important verse which we recited in tonight's Tarawih session. And the verse is, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اتَّقُوا اللَّهَ وَكُونُوا مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ All believers, so all those who believe, fear Allah, and be from amongst those who are truthful. So be from amongst those who are true and truthful. So in this verse, Allah the Almighty is saying to the believers, first of all, fear Allah. And we've been mentioning for the past sessions, past probably five, six nights, in relation to taqwa, where Allah the Almighty, a number of times in the Quran, He mentions about taqwa. And in relation to many aspects of worship, that the purpose is taqwa. And the essence is taqwa. Just like fasting, the purpose of fasting is to inculcate the quality of taqwa in ourselves. So here again, Allah the Almighty is mentioning fear Allah. And straight after He mentions, be from amongst those that are truthful. So be from amongst those that are truthful. Stay in the company of the truthful. And in the Kitab that Imam Allah He mentions, who are the truthful? Who are the Sadiqeen? The Sadiqeen over here, it refers to, according to Ibn Kathir, Ma'a Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that be from amongst those or stay in the company of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions. Now obviously, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the companions are no longer present with us in this world. So, the scholars mention that we have to stay in the company of those who have the same qualities of the Prophet and his companions. So those individuals that follow the footsteps of the Prophet and the Sahaba. So basically, we have to stay in the company of good people, pious people. This is what this verse is trying to tell us. And it has been attributed to Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, that he mentions, إِنْ أَرَدْتَ أَنْ تَكُونَ مَعَ الصَّادِقِينَ فَعَلَيْكَ بِالزُّهْدِ فِي الدُّنْيَا If you want to be from amongst those that are truthful, then you need to hold on to abstinence. You need to make sure you have a sense of detachment from this world. So many of us obviously want to be from amongst the truthful, like Allah mentions here and orders us, meaning we want to be from amongst the pious individuals, we want to stay with the pious people. So Hasan al-Basri, rahimahullah, over here is mentioning that if you want that, then you need to detach yourself from this worldly life. What he's trying to say is, sometimes we attach ourselves so much to this worldly life that we forget our purpose of life, our real purpose of life, which is to please Allah the Almighty, to worship Him, to work for the hereafter. Our goal is to please Allah and hopefully end up in Jannah, Jannatul Firdaws, inshallah. So, Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah is saying, you're only in this world temporarily. So, don't attach yourself to this world so much that you forget about Allah, you forget about your obligations, you forget about the commands of Allah, you forget about the commands of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, etc. So don't attach yourself so much to this world that you lead yourselves astray. And scholars mention a great example in relation to this. If we look at a baby when it's in the mother's womb for approximately 9 months, then what happens? The baby becomes accustomed to the mother's womb. It becomes so used to the company of the mother's womb, the atmosphere of the mother's womb, that when it's time to give birth, when the mother is about to give birth and it's time for the child to come to this world and come into a new atmosphere, come into new company, then what generally happens, the baby starts crying. The baby starts crying. And the scholars mention that the reason the baby starts crying is because it has become so used to the mother's womb, it has become so accustomed to the mother's womb, the atmosphere in the mother's womb, that it wants to stay in there. And now all of a sudden, it has been let out into this new world, into this new atmosphere, and it doesn't like it because it's not accustomed to it. So obviously it starts crying because the baby does not like this new atmosphere. And it has been in this old atmosphere, the mother's womb, for the past 9 months. So scholars mention that we shouldn't attach ourselves so much to this world, so much to this world, where when the time of our death comes, we start crying and we start saying to the angel of death, please give me respite. Or we start remembering the world, we start remembering the wealth, we start remembering the assets, we start remembering all the worldly life, and we forget Allah at the time of death. We forget the commands of Islam. We forget the kalima at the time of death. So don't attach yourself so much to this world that at the time of death you start crying that now you're going on to a new life and you can't take it because you've become so accustomed to this worldly life. So don't attach yourself so much to this world that at the time of death you regret it. So this is a very insightful piece of information. And in this verse that we recited, where Allah the Almighty mentions, stay in the company of good individuals, stay in the company of the pious, it's something that is very important in this world. Not just for a few seconds, not just for a few moments, not just for a couple of days, but this is a lifetime thing where you stay in the company of good. Because if you stay in the company of bad individuals, bad people, then your shapes are thought negatively. Your shapes are formed negatively. And your actions are formed negatively when you stay in the company of negative people or bad people, evil people. Then it has an impact, and you may not be able to see it, but slowly but surely, the impact rubs off on you. So we need to stay in the company of good people, and that is why it comes in a prophetic narration: "Al-mar'u 'ala dini khalili," that man is on the religion of his friend. Man is on the religion of his friend. What does this mean? This means that if you have good company, if you stay in the company of good people, if you have good friends, then they will able to positively impact you, they'll be able to guide you to the right path, and you'll have positive traits in you, you'll pick up positive qualities. Whereas if you stay in the company of bad individuals, bad people, then bad qualities will rub off on you, and you will start adopting those bad qualities. You may not be able to see it. And if they are really bad people, your whole religion could change. And you could just lose the plot, you could become misguided. So it's a severe matter to stay in the company of good people, stay in the company of pious people, pious friends. And for the parents, they need to make sure they worry about their children as well from a young age, to make sure they are in good company. Because many parents, they'll allow their children to go out, for example, and they won't care about their company, they won't do much research, or they won't ask much about who the friends are, what's their background, etc. They will just let them go with their friends and do whatever they want. But this will have a negative impact if they are bad friends. And nowadays, because we live in a global village, we live in the times of these scientific advancements and technological innovations. So we've got like the smartphones, we've got the gadgets, so everyone's glued onto this technology. And many times people don't go outside and they don't interact with each other because we live in a more social setting with social media, etc. So now our company is when we have our gadgets with us, whatever we are searching online, whatever social media sites we are searching or whatever we are on, whatever we are watching, this is our company. So we need to see what are we looking at, what are we watching, what are we making ourselves acquainted to, etc. Online, on the technological gadgets, on the scientific advancements, etc. And this is our company. Obviously, if we are watching bad things, if we are watching things that are harmful for our religion, against the teachings of the Quran and Hadith, then that means we are in bad company. And that means we are going against this Quranic verse. So I pray Allah the Almighty give us all the ability to understand the importance of staying in good company. I pray Allah the Almighty give us all the ability to be with pious people at all times.
Amen.
I pray, Lord, the Almighty give us all the ability to be pious. And I pray, Lord, the Almighty give us the ability to act upon everything that has been said. Amen. Wa'akhir da'wana and alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala sayyidi al-mursaleen. Allahumma rabbana faghfir lana dhunubana wa kafir anna sayyatina wa tawfana ma'al abrar. Allahumma rabbana zalamna anfusana wa illam taghfir lana wa tarhamna lanakunana min al-khasirin. يا دافع البليات ادفع بلياتنا. يا قاضي الحاجات اقضي حاجاتنا. يا قاضي الحاجات اقضي حاجاتنا. اللهم انك عفو كريم تحب العفو فاعف عنا يا كريم. اللهم انا نسالك العفو والعافيه والمعافاه الدائمه في الدنيا والاخره. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم اعز الاسلام والمسلمين. اللهم تجاوز عن امه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم اغفر لامه محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم انا نسالك من خير ما سالك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. ونعوذ بك من شر ما استعاذك منه نبيك وحبيبك محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. انت المستعان وعليك البلاغ لا حول ولا قوه الا بالله العلي العظيم. سبحان ربك رب العزه عما يصفون. سلام عليكم والسلام والحمد لله رب العالمين
يو باكورا فين وا فتاي دنيا
السلام عليكم
وعليكم السلام اي ماتيو فريند ماتيو فريند نو ويت مازوس السلام عليكم يو لاك يو باكورا سو يو يو غات ا مازوس نو 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 كاميرا